In 1750, Daniel Custis, a wealthy man in Virginia, married a woman named Martha Dandridge. They had two children, but then Daniel died, and Martha remarried a young officer named George Washington. A few years later, Martha's daughter died. Her son John, whose nickname was Jackie, got married and had four children. Jackie died of disease at Yorktown. His wife, Mary, taking her older two children with her. George and Martha adopted the two younger children. They were Nellie and Washy. A few years later, George Washington became the first president of the United States. Nellie and Washy were the first children to grow up in a presidential household. After George and Martha died, Washy wanted to do something special for his adoptive father. Right across the river from Washington, D.C., there is a hill. Washy built a beautiful house on top of the hill so everyone in Washington, D.C. could see the house and remember George Washington. He named the house Arlington. Washy got married and they had one surviving child named Mary. She married a young army officer named Robert E. Lee. After Washy and his wife died, Mary and Robert inherited the house. They lived there until the Civil War. Robert went off to fight for the Confederate Army, and Mary fled the house for safety. During the Civil War, the United States buried its soldiers all around Arlington House. That way, Mary and Robert could never come back. The United States continued to bury soldiers on the hill ever since, and the hill would become Arlington National Cemetery. In 1955, Congress made the house a memorial to Robert E. Lee. Today, we see the house for other things as well. To remember George Washington. To remember the hundreds of enslaved people who lived at Arlington. And to remember the thousands of people who died for American freedom everywhere. Let's go visit the memorial. Arlington House still stands at the top of the hill in the middle of Arlington National Cemetery. After walking up the hill, we took a tour of the house.
In this room, Robert E. Lee decided to not fight for the U.S. Army.
Instead, he joined the Confederate Army to fight for Old Virginia. This is Washy. He would use this room to create paintings of George Washington. The house has been restored to make it look like it did when Mary and Robert lived here.
With China and silver.
I like reading all the information plaques that tell you about that house.
Mary Lee had to flee the house quickly when the Civil War began.
There were a lot of memories here. In this room, she and Robert were married.
They saved most of the Washington treasury, including the bed where George Washington died.
Arlington House was the first monument built for George Washington. The Washington Monument in D.C. was built many years later, but you can see it from Arlington House. Behind that house, you can see the slave quarters where the enslaved people at Arlington lived and worked.
This is the kitchen where the enslaved people worked.
After the Lees left the house, a village of free people was built here and thrived until the end of this century. Here I learned about the qualities that make a community successful.
School and jobs. Safety. Family and friendship.
Another building nearby involves the legacy of Robert E. Lee, who led the Confederate Army. How should we tell the story of Robert E. Lee?
Sadly, like an emotional story, because he chose the wrong side.
The many stories at Arlington help us remember that the past is complicated, just like the present. And the more we learn, the better off we'll be.
See you at the next park!